Hello for Friday, January 2nd, as we start 2009. You know, looking back, we've all seen ads for websites and guarantees that their website is the best and going to give you the best results and so forth and so on. Well, the proof is actually just in the results, and we had 890 stocks hit their buy or short sell points in 2008. All of them made profits, some only intraday, some for weeks at a time. 15 alone just on Wednesday. Amazing way, with this year being as bad as it is, the third worst year, to have 890 stocks. So we look forward to 2009 for great opportunities. Whether the market drops another 50% is probably will not affect the possibilities of good trading results. So as we start, let's take a look first at one of the stocks that we featured in the newsletter. And we rarely do that, especially with ETFs, but in this case, DXO, because of its great performance a week ago Friday, as it gapped down and then with good volume right in here started moving up. We featured it showing both the logarithmic and the linear scale to show you exactly why we figured it's going to go back up to this trend line around the $3 area. Because of this big reversal, that was a good signal, and so we're really strong in that. And I say it's not too often, but in that case, and of course it did fill that, ran up about 40% from this buy point as it filled that gap on Monday. So this was a good one. And look, this just shows you a lot of people like to wait. They don't like to buy low. I don't know why it is. People just don't like to buy low. We talk about this, and yet even 2 days later, people say, well, when should we buy? Well, you should buy at the lowest possible. Instead, they're looking at this. People late in the day, when it hit three, were probably buying it. Well, you can see the volume. So the next target, if this goes higher, but now we're not as bullish on it because we've already gained 40%. But now you have to switch to a lower time frame chart, not a daily. But you can see 363 would be the next resistance area. If we look out now, that is the log scale. That's the linear scale. This is the log scale. So even on the log scale, which pushed, as you can see, a different dimension altogether, it doesn't show that the same breakout as we had shown on the way you look at it on the other chart. But you can see here it got to that trend line as well. Just another way to look at it, but now shift to your 15-minute chart. A couple of other ones that we like when they're lower price and they've been moving up that we featured in the newsletter as well. Was, for instance, our coal company, AWSR, and you can see it made new highs as well. Volume has been picking up also. You can see one thing in the future. Now, this can come back, maybe it'll dip back down into this area again. But you can see as this 200-day moving, exponential moving average is moving sideways, the 50-day is moving up. So when they eventually cross, this will be a golden cross, and that will be, of course, a good signal for a longer-term gain as well as this moves up. Another one from the watch list as well coming up is ERFW. This is ERF Wireless, and of course we originally talked about this on the blog when it was down at this area because it dropped below the trend line. Then we said in the chat room as well, this is a good buying area in here because it just looked like a very bullish chart going forward. And of course it's been moving up nicely as well since we mentioned it, and the volume has been increasing as well, and so we look for further gains. And next, of course, it's got several resistance areas in here. Then this 39 area would be the 200-day EMA. As we look at the indices and how they did, first off, we'll look at the 60-minute chart of the Dow. You can see for the week as it broke above this trend line and then continued up, it ran into the 200 period. That's in the 60-minute chart, and it came down basically to the 50 period. It's typical in all time frames that they can bounce between the two. So it bounced back down, tested, and then it was able to break out and move higher. We'll look at another time frame where we can see some resistance, but basically you look at this 8960 area over here. This would be the high point resistance as well. You can see on the 60-minute chart, we're already above RSI 70. Actually, we closed right at 69. They were above it and just dipped just a little bit lower. So you can watch stochastics to see if it's going to dip lower. On the shorter time frame chart, as it pulls up here, oh, we're back into that one. Never mind. We've already this is just showing you the overall. Here we've got the 50-day EMA at 81. Let's take a look at this a little closer. 88.56. This would be resistance. If it gets back over, then we're looking back into this area where it got up to the 99,021 area was the high it was over at this point. So that's what we're looking for. Now on the Russell, first seeing which time frame we're looking at in the beginning, we've got the daily. So you can see on the daily, it has closed over the 50-day EMA, which is bullish, and you can see the next target just above right here. Now, so this does look quite bullish, and it can continue, of course, if we do get a beginning of the year rally after some consolidation. If we get the January effect where people start bringing money back in that they took out of the market, then 550 area would be the next target. But when we look at a short frame chart of the Russell, you can see this we posted on the blog as well. You've seen this pattern so many times, like over here on the left. When they shoot up like this, it's going to pull back. Now, this won't affect the daily chart. You won't see it much, even on a steep pullback, because it could pull back and then go up. But this is a very weak pattern. Now, it can keep on going because shorts start covering and then panic buyers come in because people love to buy when it's high. They hate to buy when it's low. So if this is what all happened in here. All the people could have bought during this consolidation or when it came to lows, but they wait and they buy when it's high. So we're looking for a short on this on Friday or on Monday at the latest. You'll look at the RSI when this drops below, and if we break this kind of support area, there'll be a short. Now, there may be dip buyers coming in. Depends on the mood of the market as we go forward. Okay, what else do we have coming up? We've got, I guess, just additions to the watch list for Friday. We're not adding a lot today because we have the newsletter coming out, and it's probably going to be a slow trading day beginning of the year. We'll see how that works out. First off, we've got STP over about $12. Its recent high was $12.49, but I think if it consolidates in here for a while and then breaks above 12, it can probably trade again higher on that area. Now we've got this is the Japanese iShares, or the ETF for the Japanese market, and you can see it set up here. It did break a little bit above there, but this is 969 was a shadow high over here, or the wick high as it is. So we think over this 969 could play on the Japanese ETF. We've got a couple more golds. Now, this one did break above. We've had this kind of set aside, and it moved above on Wednesday a little bit, but Harmony Gold, back over about this $11 area, could be a buy here, but we need increased volume. Now, with all these golds that we mentioned, sometimes you like to buy them on dips, like a couple days ago when it dipped here, instead of buying them on the breakouts. So that's for you to decide. We're pointing them out because they're pretty decent charts. Another one in the gold market would be GFI. Goldfields, as you can see, it's been hitting up against this 200-day EMA, been unable to break above it, but once that breaks above the 200-day, long-term, that may be nice. You can see eventually, maybe in months to come, this will be a golden cross as well if gold continues higher, but right now, over about 10.10 would be that top line. ABAX, over about $16.30. Now, you could wait to the 16.44 over here. But sometimes with this setup, as we have increasing volume, you can get in a little bit lower and have maybe even a safer trade than waiting for the top, because you've got a little room to play with. You make that decision. 1644 would be this horizontal. That then would be the move. Target would be 1743 or above this little trend line here, roughly around $16.30. Lastly, we've got PCR, I think back over. See, it did run high. What was its high on? I don't show it here. I do show it somewhere. I think its high was 24.27 on Wednesday. But I think over 23.85 may be a play. Had increasing volume. It did leave a little spike. It may need sideways motion. But I think over that 23.85 may be a move again. We'd be looking, if volume returns, of course, that's what we're targeting, is right up here. This 200-day is a possibility. Anyway, that's how we're going to start the year with these additions to the watch list. I hope you have a good Friday trading day. Better yet, that you just take the day off and return next week. Enjoy the 15 breakouts from Wednesday. So, but thanks a lot for coming by the site. I hope you have a good trading day, a good trading year ahead. And we'll be, by the way, we have the newsletter comes out, so it's free. If you haven't signed up for it, do so on the homepage. And otherwise, we'll be back on Monday with some new video picks for you. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.